Hi folks, this is David Kwan. So I was actually just meaning to do just a video wishing everyone Happy New Year's, and I guess just talking about me being here in Iowa at my parents' home. But I figure why not? I'll talk more, just to talk more. And just kind of look back at the year 2014, in my lens, and the bubble that I live in, this is what 2014 was like for me. And and that's to say 2014, everyone probably experienced it differently. But this is me. I'm 27 years old, but I wasn't when 2014 began. I was 26. My birthday is in May, so in the middle of the year, I grew up one more year, numerically, although we're always growing day by day, and hopefully we're always growing, but it's a balance, we learn and then we regress, and it's this continuous path to be better, to strive to be better, that I try to do to always, but at the same time always also enjoy myself, enjoy the company of others, and really be this be part of a society that we human beings are all part of, at least in this bubble that I'm in. Wow, did that really got I was really weirdly worded the way I want to say that. Anyway, I don't really edit my videos, so I'm keeping that in. So yeah, it's 2014. I began, I'm still a graduate student. I began as a graduate student in NYU. I'm majoring in social work. And this is my final year. So this is my second year as a graduate student. When I began, I was a first-year student. So there was still this kind of notion like, I don't really know how my life would be like after I graduate. All I know is I'm working towards getting this degree, this graduate degree. That's actually, it's the same major as my bachelor's degree. And what I notice is that's not the case for a lot of people that I know at my school. Their bachelor's degree, other people have psychology, sports management, journalism, English, all kinds of degrees, But I knew kind of from high school that I wanted to major in social work, and I'm continuing that as my graduate degree. Although I think this year, what was kind of eye-opening to me was learning about this other major called public administration. It's like, wow, there's a lot of courses in that degree that I wish I'd have would have known about sooner, and I wish I'd taken it sooner. But next year, I'm actually taking an MPA course, which is not not next year, but next semester, which is this upcoming semester. Sorry. And that's called, managing nonprofits. And so that's going to be really interesting course to take. I began this year at a high sc interning at a high school. And now that wasn't really my focus. There are so many things that social workers can do, and I'm really glad I got the chance to experience what school social work is about firsthand. And I've worked alongside social workers in the high school. I've had a caseload of four clients, and I did group therapy sessions, group activities, I did one-on-one counseling, and I had one case management case in which I talked with the parents. There were parent workshops, there were teacher workshops. There were all these kind of things that social workers in what their job entails in schools, in public schools mostly. So that was an amazing experience. Although by the end of April-ish, I was really getting kind of burnt. Not really because of the work itself. And I loved working with high school students. I enjoy that population a lot. And being all the other social workers that I was with was very inspiring, and being surrounded with teachers and whatnot, it's really cool work environment. But I guess myself, I didn't really like being in the school setting itself. There were a lot of personal triggers for me, and I made a blog about this way long ago, it feels like that. Being in a high school, being an intern there, just feels like such a long time now. But it's actually 2014, and the first half was 2013, of course. But it's not even that long ago. But it feels so long ago, that time, the first half of 2014, and I was really struggling in school too, in a lot of ways. I mean, I apparently ended up with good grades, good enough grades actually, so that's weird to me, but I did struggle. I was actually seeing a therapist, and I really bonded with my therapist too, so that was good in a lot of ways, but I was really struggling. I think the first half of 2014, I was doing this part-time job, but I quit that. I was being like a classroom tutor. I was also in a school setting. So maybe it was kind of being too much in a school setting, and that had a bad trigger. So that was my first half of 2014, just kind of struggling to balance between being in a high school as an intern, being in a college as a college student, and being in an elementary school as a tutor. So job, internship, school, and hardly any kind of time to just... Maybe that was a problem too. When I got home, I would just kind of think, try not... My mind would be so far away from the things I was supposed to be doing, all the obligations, the process recording, course readings, things to plan for the job and the internship at home. I was supposed to be doing stuff, but instead I was at home playing video games and watching Netflix. Second half of 2014, some money issues. So parents decided to move to Iowa, and my dad came first. It was really my dad's coming to Iowa was really, I want to say it was because of my dad, although my mom has been itching to get out of Tennessee for a while. They've been there for about 4 years, so and some things happened there that I really can't talk about on public. But, you know, so they've been itching to move. My dad got a new job, found a new church here. You know, he's a pastor. So that's why my parents kind of usually end up in interesting areas. My mom's a nurse, so we ended up first in Bakersfield, California when I was 10 years old because my mom found a job as a nurse in a hospital in Bakersfield, California. So it's really the job that, you know, brings people to where they're going to be in many cases, and that's the case for my family. My dad found a church here to be a pastor in, so he's now a pastor at a church. Right, the church is so close to the home. That's actually the reason my parents bought this home, to be that close to the church. So it's walking distance. That's how close it is. But yeah, helping them move here during the summer break was itself a big challenge too. And my dad moved into an apartment there. My mom was staying in Tennessee as a nurse. In the hospital there, so it's just like my mom has to eventually to move into Iowa. But the question is, how do we make that transition happen? Can my mom find a job in Iowa as a nurse in time? And then my mom also looked into this house. Buying this house was, oh my gosh, that was a big challenge. I was almost like, man, I. This is another video that I have to do, but being a son of immigrant parents, and I'm an immigrant myself with them, but you know, I just because I came here when I was so young, I'm fluent in English. My parents are not, and that is a challenge itself. And there's a lot of things that they don't know about, like the American economic system and buying a house. They bought a house before, but before the whole 2008 financial collapse. So it was so much easier back then. Now, because of the financial meltdown and collapse, you know, buying a house, the process is really ridiculous now. But that was quite a challenge. So the whole moving thing kind of happened after I came back to New York. Just kind of going over the phone, like the documents they needed, and I also was the primary contact person for the mortgage loan person for my parents. So it was a weird thing, you know. It was the people who were selling this house called me to talk to my to send a message to my parents. I called my parents, send a message. My parents responded. Then I called I was this liaison who, because my parents don't know English that well, and so that was kind of my interesting role that I had to play for that. So in any case, my parents bought a home in Iowa. When my dad came to the house first, because my mom was still working her job as a nurse in Tennessee. But where was my train of thought? Oh yeah, so he got here, and apparently my dad was telling me this house was not in a good state. He had to fix up a lot of things here. The whoever owned this house just kind of left in a hurry. Like, oh yeah, we sold the house, and they were like desperate to sell the house, and that's why we were able to kind of buy this house. But yeah, so I'm finally here. I see how things are now, and I could see the work that kind of my dad and my mom helped too, put into making this home really quite nice. I think of all the places that my parents have been in, minus the humongous house that we owned back in the early 2000, when we were in California, this is actually a really nice home. And my parents, it doesn't seem like they would mind kind of living here forever, so it's good to be here. And and my second half of 2014, at least, actually, I feel pretty proud. I'm in an internship where, like, I feel like it's on the same path as what I want my career to be, which is to be a social worker that serves the homeless population or people who are about to be homeless and need kind of help with affordable housing and kind of services because they're poor and poverty and homeless. That's in social justice. That's kind of my passion. And being in this internship, that is so I can't really say what my internship is yet. I'll probably be able to say a lot more about it in retrospect after graduation, after I finish my internship. But where I'm at right now is an incredible opportunity for me. This sounds really selfish, in a lot of ways, but there are connections to be made at my internship. But it is a very important position. I don't have a caseload of clients. That's the first time for me. This is my like fifth or sixth internship. I've been in a lot of social work internships so far because I have a bachelor's degree in social work. But this is the first time where I don't have individual clients that I'm talking to one-on-one every week. Don't have a caseload of clients. And I'm doing all these other kind of things that I've never really done before as a social work intern. Drafting documents that have legal implications. Or helping to draft and looking over and making suggestions and ideas which can influence a document that impacts thousands of lives. That's the kind of thing that I've never imagined myself doing, but as an intern, that's what I'm doing. It's crazy and in a good way. And I'm so pumped to be there. And that in some ways I was really ambivalent about coming to my parents' home for winter break or taking a winter break at all. Because there was this project I was involved in at my internship, and I think I'm a key member in this project, and it kind of worries me, not being there and just assisting or guiding that project to come along nicely, because by the time my winter break is over and I come back to my internship in January 13th, the second phase of the project will be finished. I helped a lot with the first phase of the project, but the second phase will be finished, and the third phase I'm not going to be part of the third phase, so I hope it went well while I was away at winter break, but I don't know, I feel like it's kind of my baby, and it's so weird to be like not being a part of that right now because I'm taking a winter vacation, spending Christmas with my family. And the courses that I was taking this year was also really related to my passions, very macro-focused, social justice-oriented things, because the social work that I'm interested in is not really about therapy or psychotherapy or anything or clinical work or things like that. That stuff is important to me, but I've learned so much about that already as as a BSW and as a first-year MSW student. And now, in second year, I'm finally starting to do more things. You know, one of the course I took in 2014, in second half, was called International Poverty Reduction. And that course was so challenging. We read these three amazing books and so many articles, and it just kind of really broadened my mind. And I hope to kind of make a lot of blogs where I talk about some of the articles that I've read, and just kind of, I don't know, just tell you guys what I learned. And maybe that will be interesting, maybe not, I don't know. But that was one thing. And it's that class, it's interesting to me that my finals week was actually really fun for me, because I was doing a different thing for each class. For the International Poverty Reduction class, I made a PowerPoint presentation, a 20-minute presentation on an international NGO. And my focus was this organization. Many of you should be familiar with this organization called Medicine Sans Frontières, which is Doctors Without Borders here in the United States, or MSF for short. So I did a presentation on them. It was very timely because right before the day of the presentation, or 2 days before, on The Daily Show, Jon Stewart interviewed the executive director of the United States branch of MSF. So that was pretty. I was like, wow, this is really cool. I could use this material for my presentation. For my practice class, I made a Pinterest website called Social Work for the Homeless and did a presentation on that. And kind of, I'm still in the process of improving that, but that was my final project for that class. And, you know, for my human behavior class, it was a typical final paper. And for my social work research class, it was just an exam. So all four classes, I was doing very different things for the final. And that actually made it much easier for me. I wasn't spending, the typical finals weeks for me is reading a lot in order for me, and using what I read and taking notes on that and using those notes to write final papers. You know, typically they're 8 to 10 page papers. Sometimes I write a lot and they can be like 15 page papers. But since they're double spaced, that actually means they're actually just like 7 page papers. But, you know, I didn't write just papers for this finals week. So that was really cool. I did really good in all my classes. My internship, like, I'm really, it feels so good to kind of have this sort of respect and trust from my superiors, from people who I work with, and I guess everyone. You know, my internship is kind of boring office work. I do miss having clients. You know, part of the reason that I love doing social work is I love having that direct one-on-one interactions and group interactions with people whom I'm serving, whom I'm working for. So I really do miss that, and that was one of the best things about being in an internship in the high school. It was so fun to and so just rewarding to support the students, high school students, socially, emotionally, or whatever way I could that's not academically. You know, as a social worker, that was really fun. That's kind of the opportunity to do that in this current internship isn't there. But I look to the future of, you know, graduating and then finally doing social work for the homeless. As with the master's level kind of qualifications and thinking and training and learning. And that's exciting. I don't really know if I'll get connected the right way, and there's still a lot of obstacles and tumbles along the way that I should expect to have that will be very challenging and I might not be able to meet. But for the most part, I think 2014 was a pretty, very successful year for me. I think one of the things that I ended up doing that I'm not so proud of is I used Seamless a lot, which did quite a number on my financials, because I was eating so much out, whereas I used to be more on kind of making food for myself as a vegan. You know, that's kind of what I have to do. But there are ways to kind of get food from places that are vegan-ish. So, like, sweet potato rolls from a Japanese place, you know, one way to do it. But I did spend a lot of money on eating out, so money-wise, not doing so hot at the end of the year. And just really have to hope that when I graduate, you know, I get... Don't know. I'm not really thinking that far ahead at this point. I'm sure I'll focus more on, during March time, the crunch time is there. And at the end of January, I'm taking a civil service exam. That will help me also to think more clearly about the future ahead. But 2014, me personally, in my personal bubble, was a pretty, at least the second half was a pretty successful year. First half, I'm surprised I didn't just kind of fizzle out and burn out. There were moments in the first half of 2014 I was like, I'm not sure if I can continue doing this, and feel like such a failure. You know, those kind of thinking that happened, but my therapist really helped with that one. So, yeah, that's I guess that's 2014 in my personal level. You know, around the world, in the country, in New York City, a lot happened. So much happened, you know, and what's kind of been going around in New York City right now is, you know, this tension between NYPD and Mayor de Blasio, the issue of race politics, racism in the communities, and Ebola, and it's true. So many things happen, you know, but they always do, and now there's kind of talks about, anyway, but that's kind of the world events or news events, whatever. I'm sure I'll make more videos talking about that kind of stuff. This video was really just more really personal, you know. It's also a juggle for me too, to doing this on YouTube, making a video showing my face, and it's a privilege to not be not get any death threats or harassment by doing this. So I feel very fortunate, and thank you guys for watching and not doing that. And enjoy your, appreciate all kinds of, you know, positive and honest comments that I receive, and even emails I get. I'm just so floored, you know. But it is just a juggle to kind of let out, like, what do I want to, like, not ever reveal, you know, to and keep private. But then this is kind of personal info that comes out. But I think for the most part, I haven't really made any mistakes where I think, like, oh my gosh, you know, I posted this video, like, that's so personal, like, why would I ever do that? You know, I've never really made that mistake. And if I do, you know, not many people watch my videos anyway, so it's easy to just kind of delete them. But I really haven't had to do that. Anyway, now I'm just rambling. But that was my 2014 in review. Thank you so much for watching, and cheers.